Inside Golf Magazine is brought to you in part by Golf.com, the number one website in golf. Visit Golf.com today for the best golf stories, golf coverage, and online golf video. Now, we're joined by PGA Tour professional Stewart Cink, who tells us how he uses top instruction to keep his game at its best.
For a long time, I thought that having no coach was a good way for me to play because I played by feel and I just I used my shots to sort of get the feedback, and I just went from there. When I reached a certain level, I realized that I really didn't have an idea what I was doing. I mean, I was playing golf shots, but they were very loosely connected. If I started hitting it crooked one direction, or if I developed a pattern in my shots, I didn't know where it was coming from. So Butch has taught me so much about not only my swing, but the golf swing. So now, where I know if I hit some shots in a row, maybe they're left, a couple of shots left, I know what's going on in my swing to where I can address it. Now, I don't always fix it. I try to, but I don't always do it. But I usually have a great idea of what I'm doing wrong. And my caddy, too. My caddy's worked with me for now 11 years, and he knows my swing really well. He knows what Butch tells me. And it's great to have somebody with as good of a golf mind as Butch Harmon to help you understand your own move so that when you're going wrong, you can make adjustments out there because, you know, the round's 4.5 hours long. You don't have the luxury of stopping at the turn and going to hit some balls. You got to fix it on the fly.
The Inside Golf Magazine Top 100 Golf Lesson is brought to you by Titleist, the number one ball in golf.
I'm Roger Gunn, Golf Magazine Top 100 Instructor. One thing that's really important to understand is the shape of the swing and how it works. Lots of folks struggle on the golf course because they're dealing with the wrong premise. They think the swing is supposed to work one way when it's really supposed to work another. Let's describe it this way. I want you to imagine for a second that the ball is up in the air, like a baseball. You could see now that a swing that's shaped in this fashion would match really nicely with where that ball is. If you were to picture a big pane of glass resting here, we could call that a swing plane. So if you ever hear that term, that's what they're talking about. You could see now that that swing matches with where the ball is. Also, if you were to look down from above, you would see a circle that's going around me. So it's not a straight line motion. I don't try to take it back straight, and I don't try to bring it through straight either, even though I want the ball to go straight. It's a circle that goes around me. Now, of course, my ball's not up here. It's down on the ground. So if I put my ball back on the ground and I tilt that swing plane with it, it now goes up into the air behind me like this. Now a swing that's in this shape is in a good spot to hit that ball. It's still a circle that goes around me, but that circle is now tilted. Now remember, that swing plane is related to where the ball is. As the club gets shorter, the ball becomes closer to me, and that swing plane is now more up into the air. With a longer club, the ball is farther from me. Now that swing plane gets flattened out a little bit. Now another element that's really important is how the club face works. It's much like my hand when I clap. It goes from open to closed around me. It's only square for that moment of contact. Lots of folks try to hold the face straight as they come through in an effort to hit the ball straight. But in fact, we want to let the club swing right on around us without impeding the closing of the club. Let it go ahead and close right on around you. Now you can see here when you're looking down the target line where the club ends up at the top of the backswing. You can see how it's more over my shoulder and not just straight up in the air over my head. From the front view, you can see how the club is closing right on around me in that circular fashion. No effort to hold the club straight here. Just let it swing right on around you. So remember, it's a tilted circle around us, and let that club face close. If you can do that, you're in business.
When Inside Golf Magazine returns, you'll learn more about new irons for your game from TaylorMade, Callaway, and Cleveland Golf.